Greetings. I'm going to start this video. I just received a notification of this video from In Truth by Grace, which is a sister in Christ, who published this video to give believers a heads up on YouTube closing down accounts without any notification, just shutting down accounts that aren't commercially viable. I'm not going to go into the whole video, but you can watch that in your own leisure. Basically, if YouTube are targeting, now I'm considering the motive and method behind this is to, I believe, shut people down from sharing the gospel, sharing the truth, sharing any expose of criminals and evil machinations on public networks. So it's it looks like a move. I've heard it a few witnesses about this happening, and at first I was a bit skeptical, but listening to this video and testimony and account that people have had their emails, their YouTube accounts closed, and that eliminates the email Gmail associated to that account, so it will rub out all contacts that you may have in your email account. So I just want to give this video on the back of really persecution and targeting, and how as a targeted individual, a persecuted individual, for speaking out against corruption publicly and directly and privately, how I've been targeted and isolated. And this is on the back of getting a phone call on Christmas Eve, which is today's date, in the morning, of a doctor referring me to a mental health access, point of access, who were, the doctor referred me to them, saying that I was mentally unstable. So this is the kind of dirty machinations that these people are in covenant with, all these bodies, these powerful bodies that try and control the media and shut down the truth, and just dominate the flood the public network with a load of toffee, with a load of just gunge, load of leaven, and traffic the filter out what's true, and persecute that which is telling the truth to try and silence free speech and deem you as a conspiracy theorist or a nut job or this, that or the other. So I wanted to start this video, and really this is to targeted individuals and also the perpetrators of that targeting. So I'm going to start by just recommending to share this what's going on, that YouTube are closing down accounts, and with that they shut down your email, so you'll lose all your contacts, all your messages, all your personal correspondence with people. It'll just be erased. Now I was a bit skeptical at first, but apparently reviewing this and checking it out, and hearing other witnesses of it happening, I sort of got my attention. So maybe you should consider this and look at what's going on, and be aware that if you're not a commercially monetized website or YouTube site, there is a likelihood that you are a target to be closed down, whether you're a truth exposure or a exposer or a Christian ministry. You may be on the hit list. So I'm going to start this video with just sharing this account. Right, greetings folks. I suppose it's Christmas time, it's Christmas Eve, and I'm just sharing a testimony and outreach in faith, really. I'm kind of overwhelmed with where to start with this video. I've got so many things on my mind, and this is on the back of a dirty guileful device, really, and a consistent device against me. Now you may think I'm paranoid, but I'm just being honest and true, and I want to give an account of I've already made a video which I'm going to post with this video, but today, on the back of if you watch my video about the doctor refusing to unregister me, so I don't want to regurgitate news I've already stated, which is, doesn't get a listen, doesn't get a hearing, doesn't get taken any credence, and the doctor is playing a dirty game, and I saw this coming, and so as it's falling on Christmas, I'm going to include some thoughts about the Christmas and the gospel message, the Christmas message this season, and some thoughts of about what's been going on in the year, and what's afoot. But this today was on the back, doing this video really is on the back of receiving a phone call this morning from Point of Access Mental Health Services, which was referred, they were referred to by my GP. Now they're not my GP because I refused the registration 2 years ago, and they've refused to respond to my letters. And my suspicion is that they can hold the authority to claim that they're still my doctor when they're not my doctor. And I have no advocacy, no legal ear to listen. They don't care. And I got a phone call today from this service concerned for my health. And I basically asked them why they were ringing, and explained to them that I'd written to my doctor and refused their registration, and I'm not their registered doctor as far as I'm concerned, and they refused to give me any information. So the GP surgery is past. I wrote to them a few months ago. If you watch my video, I documented it and given them an account, and again I've not heard any response. So they wait till it goes cold, and now they've phoned up this Point of Access service, and they've rung me and saying that they're concerned. Now, to me, I know that this is just a dirty device to aggravate me and trigger anxiety, and then they play the long game. So I can perceive that what's afoot and what their game is. So they've not acknowledged my lawful request and my father's to not be registered to that GP, and I'm not going to explain all the history of that because I've already explained it in a previous video. But the phone call this morning is just like, well, if they cared, why do they ring you up on Christmas Eve and dump this on an individual? And apparently they're supposed to be aware of mental health symptoms. So if I did have any mental health symptoms, that's not going to help them, is it? You know, to ring someone up on Christmas Eve and say that, we're a mental health service out of the blue, as if that's not going to cause you anxiety and concern. So I've been praying not to get, because I'm really angry, you know, this is disgusting, guileful, wicked behaviour, how the GP, which is on the back of a history of them trying to cover up their mistakes and preying on my vulnerability and isolatedness, and hence why I done this video at the beginning of how the mainstream powers, they who are a covenant conspiracy of wickedness to Antichrist, to block any real truth and control the public mediums of and pumping it full of all popularist crap, rubbish, excuse my language. And I've just been praying not to let my anger overtake me and to remain vigilant, sober. I've been reading the scriptures in Peter, you know, place all your cares upon the Heavenly Father, and in James, take my brethren the prophets who have spoken in the name of the Lord for an example of suffering, affliction and of patience. Behold, we count them happy which endure. Ye have heard of the patience of Job and have seen the end of the Lord, the Lord is very pitiful and tender at mercy. So I'm just placing my waiting upon the Lord, putting my trust upon the Lord, and to not fall for the dirty machinations which I can perceive as that they're to aggravate me and then set a pitfall up the road. They're probably going to I stated this in a video, this is what I was looking for, that they wouldn't respond to my official complaint, and they try phone calls, so there's no record of a phone call, and it's their authority over my word, it's their word against my word, so there's no official history of my input, just theirs, and they can take the high ground, oh, we've done everything we can, we're really concerned, blah 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 blah. They're not concerned, and my dad's even written to the GP to have his name unregistered, and there's no response. There's and I was looking into this. You have to get your permit. You have to get the authority of your MP to put in an official complaint. So you've got to get your MP's backing before you can make a complaint. Now I've written to my MP before. They don't respond to your letters. They're not concerned. They're politically correct. So they're not going to deal with these sort of situations and machinations. And the surgery I'm dealing with are crooks, and I know that because I've been on the end of their treatment for the last 40 years of my life. And, you know, they say that hindsight is 20/20 vision, and in hindsight I can see the trail of their tail. I know exactly what their intentions are and how they play, and I've seen this in other people's testimonies, how they isolate you and they try the mental health card, oh you're unstable, and then they aggravate you with whatever means they can, whether that's people in the community to psychologically aggravate you and play mischief and get you wound up. I've got this permanent sound intrusion in my home. I've been hammered night and day with this electronic harassment, and then all that's to do is aggravate you and get you in a vulnerable, worn down state so they can turn up at the door with the police and claim that you're unstable and blah 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 blah. So I've been praying not to react, to remain calm and not let my anger overtake me, so I sin. I get too angry, and because my flesh response is to get violent and aggressive, so I'm going to guard against that and trust in the Lord's Spirit to be loving, to be patient, to be forgiving, to be trusting in Christ. And this is all on the back of Christmas. You know, Christmas is to me it's a painful time. You know, family circumstances and loss. You know, I find Christmas difficult, and then the hypocrisy of Christmas in the shops, rushing to buy presents, and gluttony, just stuffing people's faces for the sake of it, and without any consideration for the birth of Jesus Christ. And Christmas is, you know, it's a paganized cloak on the back of Christianity. It just vexes me, the hypocrisy of people. But I understand that Christians have liberty. I'm not opposed to people celebrating Christmas and in their hearts, I understand that people can, in a pure heart, worship Christmas truly, but personally, you know, I find Christmas difficult. I don't have a Christmas tree. I don't really celebrate Christmas, although it's like a dead policeman. It's difficult to avoid. So I try and navigate it the best I can with being thankful to God for Jesus Christ, for his not only his birth, but his finished work on the cross for dying for all sinners. That's the message of salvation. And Christmas to me just masks that. And discovering that Christmas really come on the back of when the Roman Catholic powers become predominant in Christianity as the church. They're not the church, they're not believers, they don't believe the Bible, they persecute Bible believers, they undermine the authority of scriptures. Reviewing the Catholic policy of if you're not a Catholic, you're deemed a heretic, and it's just for them to go after you. Any means necessary, and they use means by pumping immorality into society, and they use so many machinations to discredit the word of God and the true meaning of what Christmas should be. You know, Christmas is not just about the birth of Jesus, it's about the whole plan of salvation, and their focus is to indoctrinate it with paganized idols and images like the Christmas tree and the holly and the yule log. It's nothing to do with biblical Christianity, and I just find it a hypocrisy, and it's unavoidable, and I'm sure many brothers and sisters feel as I do. But also you can look at the good in it. It's a time to remember Jesus Christ, his not only his birth but his finished work, dying for all sins that we may be safe and safe from perishing in hell, because we're sinners, we're all sinners. But Christmas doesn't focus on that, and people just want to feast on Christmas and celebrate Christmas without the heart and soul of what it should be about. It's just just a fudge, and you have all this ecumenical speeches. I noticed on the TV there's going to be this black woman bishop who's going to be giving a talk at Christmas about and the main message is unity and uniting in peace, you know. But it hides the gospel message of repentance and faith alone in Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of sins behind its back, and teaches this unity, we all should come together in peace. Well, what about separation of the believer from the unbeliever, from the wicked? You know, the gospel is to repent, to believe in Jesus Christ and see yourself, to be convicted that you're a sinner and you're worthy of hell. And the only one who can save you is a holy God who bled and died for you and was resurrected, who rose from the grave, who overcame sin and death. He passed through hell that we could escape the eternal judgment to receive this free gift of eternal life. That's Christmas. There's nothing mentioned about Christmas. It's all paganized idolatry, and it just promotes gluttony and false worship and blasphemy, and I'm not opposed to it per se, but on the whole it's a load of rubbish, and it vexes my soul. And the Queen's speech, the Queen is a hypocrite. She doesn't stand up for the faith like she claims that she would, you know, against popery, against the Roman Catholic Church, against the teachings of Islam. It's all politically correct, and these people are whitewashed sepulchres. Like the Lord said, they're like full of dead man's bones and dust, you know, with a whitewash of appearance of righteousness. And I'm not opposed to the good works that people do, but it's just hollow, it's vain, because it throws out the cross, it throws out the true message of Christianity, which is repentance, to believe, to change your mind, to seek the forgiveness and mercy of Jesus Christ by believing and trusting in his salvation and in his atonement. So really my concerns have been for what's going on in the world, how they're persecuting, how they isolate, and coming from the perspective of somebody who's been persecuted and isolated and targeted, you know, I just want to give an outreach of by in faith, and I pray by God's will and grace that this will be a comfort, and considering that they may be closing down my website, which I'm really not that worried about. I trust in the Lord, and I'm just noticing how that they are, you know, slowly tightening the noose. They're going to be choking out people who speak up against the truth. I know I've been persecuted for it time and time again. You speak out against people, whether in a pure heart, whether in anger, doesn't matter. You're persecuted, you're marked, and you're targeted, you're a threat. And And the Catholic Church is the main protagonist of all these secret machinations through the military bodies, through the associations and the power that they hold and the influence they hold in Mammon, in the synagogue of Satan. The mass of conspiracy against freedoms, against truth and against the word of God and against the gospel, even against the Jewish people, against the word of God, anything to do with the word of God. These people want to overthrow it, destroy it, discredit it. Hence why they're shutting down Christian websites. They're going after people who speak out the truth, and they're like labeled conspiracy theorists, or they're a danger, they're a threat to the security of the nation or status quo, and they're persecuted by second, third, fourth hands, by people in ignorance who follow what they're told or what they're paid to do or what they're asked to do, whether that's in covenant conspiracy or whether by ignorance. It seems that the media are tightening the noose on freedom of speech. So I don't know how long people have got to get their voices out. Because you get all these people who've suffered traumatised abuse, whether that's sexual abuse, whether that's social engineering abuses, covert social engineering and abuses through the establishment, through the corruptness within the establishment, under the guises of the people who serve it, thinking they're doing good works when they're actually, in actual fact, is serving a more wicked agenda that organises and regulates the whole body and controls the oversees all the work, so they can operate and access information, access, correlate information, and get the heads up on what's going on, so they can control. They can have control over people. So this is going to be an outreach to perpetrators of my targeting, because they know who they are, and I know that they will be monitoring what I post on YouTube, and I know there's an intelligence body that correlates my activities so that they can plan their next move. And I'm not paranoid, I am experienced in the process. I'm on the end of it, although I'm isolated, and so I wanted to share just my testimony publicly, how they are persecuting me, how they are targeting me, a vulnerable person, someone who's traumatised as a child. I've got a complex post-traumatic stress disorder. They've not diagnosed that. I've learnt that through my Saviour Jesus Christ and study, and coming to the knowledge of my actual abuse and how I was dissociated for about 36 years of my life, and I've learned this through all the failures of the mental health system, or the NHS, the care system, who don't want anything to do with this. They're disingenuine. It's all lip service, and it's all bogus, and they're all lawless. They are supporting a lawless government, a lawless nation, in apostasy and wickedness. And that's the truth, unfortunately. With all this Brexit, you can see from the results of the election that you might have hope in President Prime Minister Johnson. But my hope's not that. I'm not so naive to think that this is it. Things are going to get better now. I can only see that it's going to be hammered out of what deal and what negotiations are going to be with Europe. I see a machination. I'm not so hopeful, and I see that this is going to be a long drawn out process to wear people down, and then further up the line it will be proselytised that, oh, we're better off in Europe, let's go back, let's rejoin the EU. And they hold behind their back that it was illegal to go into the EU in the first place. Like they held back what David Cameron said, in or out. There was no mention of a deal. Then you got all these politicians fighting against no deal to make it illegal. Well, that's what people voted for. And that's what was called out for, and that's why all these liberal politicians, these Labour politicians, have been judged, because they oppose what was legally voted for. So they've all got their comeuppance, but they're not going to humble themselves, they're not going to repent and then support President Johnson, whether his intentions are genuine or whether the man's in ignorance. But I don't trust any man, any flesh, any politician, because I've tasted the hypocrisy and the wickedness that goes on in our society in the name of the law. You know, they use the law to their own advantage, covertly. And then when you're in the minority and persecuted, you haven't got a voice. And these are the games that they play. They threaten you. They indirectly threaten you, so there's no record of that threat. I've had threatening phone calls. There's no record of those phone calls. There's no response, no legal response to my letters and my request. So after time, it becomes their word against mine, and you're not. If you're deemed mental, you know, they rang me up this morning to say, you know, they got concerns about my mental health, and I said, well, you've been lied to. I've written and requested that I want to be unregistered from that doctor. I never accept the registration, so whatever you've been told is a lie. And I said, I'm going to hang up now, and I hung up. So these people have been approached by my corrupt doctor surgery, and they're completely unaware of what's taken place before, but because of the authority of the doctors over my word, I wonder, well, whose word are they going to take, and how are they going to react to that our phone conversation? I've got no record of it. I only took down the number and recorded it. So the record will be on my phone records, but there's no, I've got no means of really recording my phone conversation except holding a dictator to the earpiece, but that's very difficult. And I didn't think to do it this morning, I just assumed it was a family member. You know, they ring you on Christmas Eve to drop that ball on your plate, and then they disappear. You don't hear from them again. I haven't had a response from my request after a year. So 2 years after a year after I requested to be unregistered, I didn't hear anything. So I waited a year, wrote back again. That was a few months ago. I don't hear anything. And what do I get? A phone call on Christmas Eve. So that's really agitated me, and I've been praying not to get angry, you know, because I have a right to be angry with these disgusting, guileful mischief makers. They're devils. So to these perpetrators, you know, you don't believe in God, you don't fear God. So I'm going to warn you, God will allow you to be hardened and hardened. And the more you reject God's will and his way and his covenants, he's merciful. He will let his people suffer. You think you can try God and think, well, where's your God? He's not protecting you, because we can have free course over you. Well, you take the rope. You carry on doing this to people. You know, whether people's lives are spent or not, this is an eternal consequence. If you continue to carry on, God will allow your heart to become harder and harder and harder. And you will go into perdition. You will go to the point where there's no coming back from it. And your judgment will be when you die. Christ has already judged you on the cross. He's died for all sinners. He died for every single sinner that in this lifetime that they could believe and receive his forgiveness and salvation. If you reject that, you're not going to know that. And you're going to think in your hard, proud hearts that you can, where's their God? Where's their deliverance? Well, I'm already delivered, whether I live or whether I die. I'm going to heaven and I know it. You don't. You don't believe, so you carry on in your wickedness. And God's outstretched for you to forgive you. Whatever you've done, he'll forgive you. You go to Christ humbly and receive his salvation. You're forgiven of all your sins, past, present and future. That doesn't justify you to continue in your sin. And he'll give you a change of heart. But if you harden your heart, you're condemning yourself. You're nailing your coffin. And then your judgment will be swift. And you won't want to come up against the eternal God, and you'll be judged eternally in hell, and there'll be no coming out of it, no crying, no appeal. Your only appeal and only advocate will be the Lord Jesus Christ. You've rejected him. You've got no hope, not in this life and not in the next. So So whatever your vain belief is, whether you think you can believe you can get away with this and God doesn't see it, God sees everything. And God is wise, he's eternally wise, and he's left the world in a state of his permissive will. He'll allow wickedness to continue, he won't intercede, he'll allow you free choice. He's done his work on the cross. And because he knows his work will be rejected, he will allow people to bring themselves into judgment. And that's where the world's going. It's under condemnation. It's heading for judgment. And all these nations that are wet and feeble and they don't stand out against paedophilia, organised corruption and infiltration of the government and breaking the law on a daily basis, they're just under judgment. And anyone who doesn't see that is ignorant. And because of their unbelief, they're under judgment. And God is still outstretched, Jesus is outstretched for those people to be saved, to call upon him to repent and receive his forgiveness. And then when you receive it, you know the love of God. And until then you won't have a witness, and if you don't believe, you'll just become harder and deader, and you'll continue, and the world will continue, bad things will continue. Then you'll get people on the back of this climate change, create all these fires in Australia. You know, they've even admitted on mainstream media that they were started by arsonists. Well, what did the mainstream media report? They mention the arsonists quickly, and then the majority of the rhetoric is global climate change, global crisis. But if we've got any global crisis, it's because of greed and industrial pollution. It's been going on for years because people get away with murder. They toxify the soil, they spill things into the sea and get away with it, and it's all put on the back of the public. Oh, it's your fault. Well, no, it's not. It's not the public's fault. It's the public's fault for allowing it and not seeing the truth. And all these political people will get on the back of this extinction rebellion and climate global crisis. The crisis is fermented, it's created to be worse than it really is. So you can be taxed, you can be choked and merchandised and then overburdened with the problem. It's a political spin. You know, I'm not saying there isn't a global problems. You know, the sea's polluted, the soil's polluted, the food chain's polluted, but that's all by those who regulate it, not by the public. The public don't have a choice what goes in food. And if they do cry out against it, they're not going to be heard. It carries on going. This wickedness carries on going because of these wicked, unbelieving people who don't fear God. So this is just on the back of my message, some things I wanted to convey. And just reach out to any of my brothers and sisters who've been persecuted. Because I've honestly felt overwhelmed, feel like throwing a towel in, but you know, I have hope in Christ. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to stick this out, wait for my Saviour to come. And if he doesn't come, I'm just still going to trust in him. I'm eternally anchored in him. I can't forsake my Saviour, because I know he's true, I know he's faithful, I know the Word of God's faithful, and I know all these hypocrites and liars who predominate the media are liars, and they're under condemnation. They need to repent and receive Jesus Christ, his forgiveness. And so does all the world in unbelief. Because you're part of the ignorance, and you're going to be deceived, because the deceived will carry on deceiving others because they're deceived and they don't know they're deceived. You only know the truth when you believe, when you receive a witness of God. Not witness a man or religion, a personal witness. But your personal salvation is yours. You need to receive it, you need to believe. And people who've believed know. It's that simple. You turn or burn, and you'll burn forever. That's why Christ died, that's why God's Son died, that's why God, the Creator, the Lord, the living God, died. He bled and died and rose again from the grave to give us the victory over sin, because we couldn't conquer sin. So we need to receive his mercy and grace and forgiveness so that we can live forever in a perfect, beautiful, just, fair world, in love, in his love, his grace. He's got high standards, he's holy, he's not going to tolerate all this lying and wickedness. And people think, well, if there was a God, he wouldn't allow this. Well, he has allowed it, because he's given his life already. Because his life's been rejected, this wickedness will carry on. God's not going to be mocked. what God has needed to do, he's done it. It's finished. It's because of the world's in unbelief that we carry on in this wickedness. You know, and the world's had enough. The world cries out, it's had enough. It's had enough of this rhetoric, this spin, this wicked, continual, perpetual thrashing of all these lies. And Christ is still merciful to the sinner. He died to save sinners, and we're all sinners. Jew, Gentiles. He prophesied that what would happen to the Jews. They'd devour themselves, and they would believe a lie, and they'd be deceived by the Antichrist in the majority, and only a branch are going to be saved. You can see it all playing out. We're in the last days of prophecy, and God is calling out on the cross to repent and believe. So I'm going to close this message in the name of Jesus Christ, in the hope that it touches someone by the grace of God, because I trust God. He said he'll use all things to his glory, and I pray for his glory in my weak, feeble life, that what I've suffered is going to make a difference to somebody, whether that's my enemy or my friend or anybody. You know, I'm here for the glory of God, not for my glory, not for my hits on YouTube. You know, I know that all YouTube's controlled. It's all controlled by a wicked body of people who filter the traffic, and they pump. They have agents that pump and allow things to be popular, and so they can control what they don't want to be popular, to become popular. And the truth isn't popular to the mass of the wicked anyway, because they're deceived in ignorance and they're addicted. They're socially engineered to be preyed upon by their appetites for addiction. You know, the people in power know what buttons to push, how to get people, lead people into the internet. It's a complete scam. The internet's not safe. It hasn't been safe from the beginning. All of the domains owned by the government, military bodies and powers. You're just getting a ride on the back of it. It's all controlled from the beginning. It's not fair, it's not just, and it's not safe. And I'm really at, I was up to there with the internet before I even got on the internet, because I could see it for what it is. It's a scam, and it's controlled, just like the mainstream media. It's controlled, just like the world. It's in the power of the devil and those who serve it. The world loves its own, and I hate the world. You know, can't wait to, you know, be with the Lord. And I pray that this has been a blessing and hope, a comfort, and a admonishment for those wicked people, and I hope that they repent, and I hope that they see soberly and come to faith in Jesus Christ and be delivered from their punishment, what God is justly going to pour out upon them. And if you reject the eternal love and mercy of Jesus Christ, you're going to get the opposite. You're going to get the eternal wrath of God for rejecting his son. It's that simple. Eternal burn. So I'm going to close there in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.